I'm using minoxidil 5% for hair loss. Now I started PRP for the same. Can I stop using minoxidil? I'm 26, male. Experiencing hair fall for the last 4 years, and a major part of my scalp was bald. Now I've gone through hair transplant, and also I did PRP. But for the rest of my hair, a dermatologist suggested to use minoxidil 5%. But another one advised me not to use it, as it has to be used lifelong and has some side effects, and also the hair fall will return in case I could not use it for some time in future. And he suggested that PRP is enough. So can I stop minoxidil and PRP will be enough?
Thank you for your question. You're 26 years old, you've already gone through a hair transplant, and you are conflicted because you've gotten opposing recommendations from two different dermatologists about basically maintenance and prevention of further hair loss. One was recommending minoxidil, while the other one is recommending that you don't use minoxidil and that you instead do PRP instead. Well, I can certainly give you some guidance as to how we counsel our patients in comparable situations. I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I've been practiced for over 20 years in Manhattan and Long Island. I've been performing hair transplant as well as non-surgical hair restoration for many years. In fact, I'm the founder of Trichostem Hair Regeneration Centers, where we have developed a system of non-surgical treatment for hair loss using PRP as well as extracellular matrix, vitamin D, and other methods that we've employed in a specialized way that we customize for every patient for both male and female pattern hair loss. So the question about PRP as well as minoxidil and finasteride and basically the universe of hair loss treatment is something we deal with every day and all day long. So I'm going to just give you a little bit of perspective as I see it when we see patients like yourself. If you've lost enough hair that you've moved ahead with a hair transplant, clearly there has to be some weight for you to keep the existing hair you've got. And when you look at the medical options, you're looking at basically two. One is finasteride, taking a pill daily, 1 milligram once a day. This is a drug that blocks the conversion of testosterone to dihydrotestosterone by an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. It has been a significant method of or a significant modality for the treatment or maintenance of hair for male pattern hair loss since the late 90s, since about 1997. Unfortunately, in recent history, there's been a lot of fear about long-term sexual side effects, which has resulted in a large-scale abandonment of this option, which leaves you with the topical application of minoxidil. Now, minoxidil does stimulate hair growth as well as prolong the growth cycle of thinning hair. But what it does not do is stop hair loss. We have patients who have been on minoxidil for over 20 years, and they are practically bald. They come to us and say, yes, I've been using minoxidil religiously every day, twice a day as recommended, for 20 years, and they practically have no hair. So the clinical evidence substantiates that minoxidil does not stop progression. When the question of PRP comes up, I use PRP in my practice for many indications. As a cosmetic surgeon, I really help a lot of patients with PRP from the assistance of improving dark under eye circles, skin quality and texture, to improve acne scars, to improve scars, to improve fine lines and wrinkles. But in my experience, PRP as a standalone treatment for hair loss has some variability and has limited long-term benefit. In general, if someone is to have PRP for hair loss, they're going to have to be on a regular scheduled treatment, typically once a month. And many people, usually by four treatments, find their way to our office, because when we offer what we call hair regeneration, which does involve PRP, we're able to sustain 5 years of growth with one treatment, which does involve PRP, but it's also a method combining extracellular matrix and vitamin D that was developed over treating hundreds and hundreds of patients over many years and developing a protocol. Some patients who have moderate to severe loss, we'll do a second treatment on, but it's not an absolutely necessary treatment, but we'll do it somewhere around 15 to 18 months. Hair regeneration has been so successful that patients are coming to us from all over the world. So to answer, as it relates to your question, if you are considering a treatment like hair regeneration, there's no comparison with minoxidil. I advise most of our patients that if they've been on minoxidil, that they can stop minoxidil after we do hair regeneration treatment. And majority of our male pattern hair loss patients come to us either having taken finasteride and having had side effects and not taking it anymore, or categorically refusing to take finasteride, which means that hair regeneration stands on its own. So I think that both dermatologists are using the best of their knowledge and experience, but unfortunately the options, medical options for hair loss, remain extremely limited. When we developed hair regeneration, we actually filled a very important void between medications and surgery, and since you've already had surgery at such a young age, it is mission critical for you to hold on to every hair that you've got in the best way you possibly can. Otherwise, in a few years, you will need another transplant, and eventually you'll run out of the donor area. So learn more about hair regeneration. I realize I've introduced another concept besides PRP and minoxidil, but speaking from many years of experience and having developed this process, I can't be as excited enough to talk to you about this treatment, which has been so successful to help so many people in our practice. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck. Thank you for your question.